everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Here we've got two teams who will look to their running backs if they want to control the pace of the game. It's the Cowboys going up against the Vikings. A year ago, our commentators would have been freezing outside. Now they're in a warm booth in a brand new stadium as we say hello to our guys in Minneapolis, Brandon Godwin and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, thank you. We are indeed at the beautiful state-of-the-art U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, on this fine Thursday night, we've got a good one in store between the Dallas Cowboys and the Minnesota Vikings. Hi again, everybody. I'm Brandon Gordon. To my left, as always, he's Charles Davis. And Charles, we saw in the open, we've got a couple of great running backs in this game tonight, each capable of putting a team on his back.
And I'm excited to talk about the runners, not just the passers, who have a big hand and who's going to win this game. Both of these guys are do-it-all, can run it, can catch it. I can't wait to get this one started.
Here's Kai Forbath now to get us started. And we are underway from downtown Minneapolis. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now the offense for the Dallas Cowboys coming on, led by Dak Prescott. They continue to roll, a win on Thanksgiving over Washington. And I know in our household that game delayed the start of Thanksgiving dinner. And Dak Prescott, one touchdown passing, another on the ground in that game.
I like your household. I want to hang out with you next Thanksgiving.
I'm just being honest.
I'm down with that. Hey, if we're going to delay it to watch some ball, I'm all for it. But here's the thing about Prescott for me. The numbers were fine, but let's go behind the numbers and just watch the poise that he plays with. Stays within himself. Maybe things aren't going perfectly, but at the end of the game, he stays unruffled and makes plays to win.
Now Prescott out left side here to Bryant. 16 yards on the game's first play and a quick first down. Partner, it was quite the battle. Washington and Dallas watching Dez go against Josh Norman. Dez finished with 5 catches, 72 yards, but a little jawing going back and forth.
Tell the truth, when you were watching the game, you started watching the game within the game, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You kept your eyes on 88 of Dallas and 24 of Washington and watched what they were doing on each and every snap. And boy, what a battle it was. An absolute fierce one. Dez's team ends up getting the victory.
They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And for Elliott, the Zeke train continues to roll, my friend. 97 more yards, 2 more touchdowns on Thanksgiving. That's number 10 and 11 now in the season.
And I think a lot of people are always looking at rookie players, especially running backs. Will they hit the so-called rookie wall? And Zeke Elliott is showing no signs of that wall being there. But I think it's because of the way they use him and the way he goes about his business. When he doesn't carry the football, he still carries out his play fakes, he still blocks, he does everything in addition to being able to catch the ball.
Yeah, if there's a wall, he ran through it. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Not too many more ideal situations in 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Fresh set of downs here. They'll run it now out of the gun and down to the 36-yard line here. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
3 yards to go on 2nd down. This is Elliott. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. It's Everson Griffin who made the tackle. And here's a look at the starting offense. Off offense coming up, needing 2 yards on third down. Prescott on third and two. They find some open field here. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. The offense lining up first and 10. On first and 10, Prescott going right side. He has Winton. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
So often you hear defensive coaches talk about we need all 11 on every play in order to be a good run-stopping unit. And sometimes it starts to sound a little cliche, but did you see the free safety on that play? Knifing through and running down the ball carrier. A huge, huge play. And when you have a free safety who can run like that, you've got to turn him loose.
Second down, Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of 7. And now it's third down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
They'll try to capitalize on play number 11 of this opening drive. Third and goal. Play action now. Prescott surveying the field. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Linval Joseph, he's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of 5, and it'll bring up fourth down. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Now Dan Bailey, 30 of 32 in field goal tries last year. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. So out now comes Minnesota. And Charles, let's discuss Sam Bradford's Thanksgiving Day performance. 31-37. Now, no touchdowns and an interception. Unfortunately for him, that interception was a costly one late.
It was, but when we look at the performance in total and we look at the growth of Sam Bradford from the time he got to Minnesota on the eve of the season, the changes they've made in the offensive staff, how they're running offense, and the state of an offensive line that's lost a lot of people, I think he's doing remarkably well.
Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jarek McKinnon. And he's going to lose yardage here, back to his own 18. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Now Bradford on second down. And he's got the hook up here. It's Kyle Rudolph. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Now, Rudolph, he's a guy, Charles, we haven't discussed a whole lot this year, but he's really a reliable tight end on Thanksgiving. He led the way for the Vikings, 9 catches, 64 yards.
Sometimes he gets lost in the shuffle, but he does have a Pro Bowl on his resume. He can block, he can get downfield and catch the balls. We saw on Thanksgiving Day, what did he have, 9 catches in that game? So we know he can maneuver it downfield. He just needs more attention.
For the year, he's almost at 500 yards, also 5 touchdowns for Rudolph. Numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Vikings. Jarek McKinnon, 72 yards. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. Well, he only needed 2 yards. It was 3rd and 2. But he found a way to make the red seed part.
And remember, it's 3rd and 2. In the NFL, that's not automatically a running down. Most of the time, it's a passing play. So in this case, now they're probably loosened up just a little bit, thinking pass. They hit him with the run, and boy, did they hit him big. Is he still going? I mean, Michael, you called the touchdown, right?
Yeah, I did. Forbath on for the extra point. He's got it. They'll see that opening drive field goal and raise it a touchdown, and that makes it 7-3. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in 3 plays. And a pretty good run there in the end to top it off. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And the Vikings defense ready to head back out there now. And they've got the lead. Last time they surrendered the field goal. We'll see what they do this go around.
And giving up 3 is never ideal because any defense wants to pitch a shutout. But that's not a bad thing in most situations. You only give up field goals, your team has a chance to win.
Yeah, they still, as I said, they've got the lead here. We'll see if they can get a stop and hold them to 0 points this time. Start the drive with Elliott. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's 2nd and 2.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense.
Here we go. One, nine.
Another carry for the rookie Elliott. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one. And a look at the Vikings defensive unit.
Garrison Smith is a player I love to watch. Whether he's ranging deep as a free safety or near the line of scrimmage where he makes more plays, keep your eyes on him.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go!
On third and one, here's Prescott. Complete to Jason Witten. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Come out here in the eye. A first down carry by Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Bryant, the lone receiver, left.
Let's go! Brad 38! Brad 38!
A second down throw for Prescott. Drops it underneath to Elliott. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Defense has to stand tall here, third and one. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Here's Morris. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one.
On every snap, a defense is trying to establish who they are, but on third and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are, and that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they're looking at their offensive line and saying, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
And Jason Garrett's going to leave the offense on the field. They're going to go for it here on fourth. Fourth down, Prescott, and that's caught by Beasley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Not only is a slant route really difficult to cover, it's a real staple play for an offense on a fourth down because it's a quick hitting play. Get the ball in the hands of the quarterback right to the receiver.
And the receiver has to be ready because that thing's coming on a rope. So the offense has it first and 10. Tenth carry now for Elliott. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13.
Come on, let's go! Brad 38! Brad 38!
They go to Elliott again. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
An extra defensive back was inserted on that play where they call their nickel defense. And what you're hoping as an offense is that they will get out of there thinking it's a pass play and create space for you to run the draw. In this case, that didn't happen. The extra DB was not blocked and made the play.
Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on third.
Playing coverage here.
Now Prescott. Got a man. It's complete. Williams. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And the seemingly endless drive continues. One quarter in the books here on a Thursday night. It's a close game here early on. We're back to Minneapolis in just a moment.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. First and 10, Prescott. It's caught on the right side, Williams. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
So now it's first and goal. Now Elliott, and he is going to lose yardage here. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him. Sat there waiting for him and made the play.
They come out here in the eye. Second down, Prescott. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. It looked like he might have had a window there, but the rhythm was just a little bit off.
Certainly was, because everything that has to come together to get a pass completed. Yeah, you're right. The sync just wasn't there.
Let's go! One, nine.
Third and long for Prescott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Dan Bailey now for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And the gadget play gets him into the end zone. Now to kick it away after the touchdown. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The defense for the Cowboys getting set to go. And a tight ball game here, and in these close ones, every drive becomes magnified.
And we don't want to overuse the word critical, but it feels that way as they head out there for this possession. They need to get the ball back and give their offense a chance to get them totally back into this game.
We'll see if the defense can do just that here. First down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Charles, let me ask you about this Dallas defense, because so much hype, obviously, and rightfully so, about the offense. But this defense, they've held their own, have they not?
Indeed they have, and in a lot of cases, they've led the charge on defense, made plays, and let's face it, going into the season, we thought they might finish last in the league in defense. They had a lot of guys suspended. They spent a second-round pick on a defender that we all knew was not going to play this season in Jalen Smith. Yet somehow, they fashioned it together, led by Sean Lee, and become a cohesive unit that doesn't worry about who gets the credit, and have had guys emerge and make plays that you didn't expect.
Well, in Week 12 last week, more limited production out of the running game. McKinnon, he was the leader, but just 9 carries, 31 yards.
And I know we immediately look at the guy carrying the ball and say, what is going on? And can Adrian Peterson get back fast enough? And there are rumors that he may be back sooner rather than later. But that offensive line, it is a shell of itself from the beginning of the season. So it's not just the guy carrying the ball. It's got to be the guys up front carving holes.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. And as we sit on the doorstep now of Week 13, need to talk playoff picture. Let's look at the AFC. The Patriots at 9-2, the Raiders at 9-2. I don't know that they're getting the credit they deserve. So many people talking about New England.
I would agree with that. They're having that type of a season, their first winning season since 2002. And they have their sights set a lot higher than that now. But how about Kansas City? They went to Oakland earlier this year and beat them by 16 points. So head-to-head, the Chiefs know that they're one of those teams that you've got to beat in the playoffs.
He's coming off a heck of a win over Denver. He had time, was able to survey the field, and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. That's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw. So here we go, first and 10 now. McKinnon. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35. Barry Church, the strong safety, the one to get him down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Off the play fake. Bradford. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. 3rd down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Oh. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. On third down, Bradford. He's got time in the pocket. And this is going to be incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And it's fourth down. So on fourth down, here's a punter, Jeff Locke, to kick it away. Lucky Whitehead back deep for Dallas. Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Encroachment, the defense. Still first down.
Elliott, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Fresh set of downs here. Again, it's Elliott, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Tackle made there by Sharif Floyd.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. His throw here's incomplete.
Receivers work all the time on making sure they catch the ball, haul it into their bodies before they turn and run. A little bit of loss of focus on that play.
Tough spot for the offense. Third and eight. Third down, it's Prescott. On the left side, he finds Beasley. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Now the offense lining up first and 10. The give is to Elliott. And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Four down.
Second down, Elliott. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Off the play fake, Prescott. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
So the Cowboys will punt it on fourth down. As on is the veteran Chris Jones to kick it away. Marcus Sherrill's back deep for Minnesota. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. Our eyes shift to the defense of the Cowboys now. They forced the punt the last time, got off the field. I'm sure some of your D coordinators through the years, you liked when you heard those words, get off the field.
Oh, there's no doubt.
Or maybe you didn't like it when you heard those words.
It depended on when they were yelling them. But in this situation, absolutely perfect. Get off the field. Force a punt, let the offense take over and do their thing, and it resulted in a field goal.
Now we'll see if they can do that again. And the first play of the drive goes to McKinnon. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
They run once more with McKinnon. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Bradford from the gun on third down. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there. And that'll bring up a fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Cowboys swarm in and it's blocked. This is gathered in and he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Partners, you well know every blocked punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
Here's Bailey now for the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. Well, we know he has home run hitting ability in the punt return department, and he showcases it there all the way back for six. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. To return, here comes Marcus Sherrills. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And now back onto the field, here comes the Cowboys defense. They sure didn't get a whole lot of rest. They had the three and out, forced a punt, but that's returned for a touchdown, so they're on the field quickly.
So they're cheering. They're happy. They like what they saw.
They're like, oh, I got to go get my helmet. Right?
But it is a quick turnaround, so we'll see how they handle that on this possession.
Here on first down, finding time, great protection, going up top, he couldn't quite hold it, got hit, ball pops out, incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
A second down throw for Bradford. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Play action now, Bradford. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. Here's Jeff Locke now. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is taken at the 23. 51 yards on the punt there. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now Dak Prescott of the offense heading back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of it. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. On first and 10, Prescott. Out left side here to Bryant. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Prescott now on second down, over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time, and now it's third down. Bryant, the lone receiver left. Looking to throw, Prescott, complete to Jason Witten. A gain of 13 and also a first down.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. First down throw for Prescott. Throw right side, complete to Williams. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that leads to a Dallas first down.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. Nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Prescott looks to throw on first. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And down inside the 15 he goes. They'll get 19 yards there. And it'll be first down, Cowboys.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
So the offense has it first and 10.
Single, slot. Hey, let's go! Nine.
From the red zone now, Prescott. This will be caught at about the 5. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Prescott yet again. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. They come out here in the eye. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Second effort there. He was determined to find pay dirt, and he did.
I think that's a great example of what coaches talk about, a back that runs behind his pads, and he uses pads to get him into the end zone.
Now Bailey to tack on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Minnesota getting ready to go again on offense. They're 6-5 right now, Charles. No Stephon Diggs. We've chronicled AP maybe coming back earlier than people have anticipated, but we'll see how this offense goes down the stretch because it's been up and down.
The problems with the offensive line have extended to everywhere else on the team because they can't run the ball with the same authority. Trying to pass protect for Sam Bradford has been a little bit difficult. You mentioned Stephon Diggs not being out there. We thought Laquon Treadwell would step in for him, the rookie number one pick. Instead, it's been Cordarrelle Patterson they've been trying to get involved in the offense. They've got to find an identity again trying to move the ball.
On first and 10. Bradford over the middle here to Rudolph. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a gain of 14 there. And that leads to a Minnesota first down. Bradford. And a quick throw here. That's complete. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. So the offense looking at a second and 8. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Second down, Bradford. Pass incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time. Third down here. A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and 8.
Blue 45.
On third down, Bradford. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 22.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Bradford on first down. A dump down to McKinnon. And he'll go down at the 28. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Second down now after the pass completion. Off the play fake, Bradford. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. And now a first down following that long gain. They come out here in the eye. They'll try to run with McKinnon. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Jerick McKinnon with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are able to close the gap just a bit.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps. But they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Forbath to add the extra point. It's up and good, so they claw back into it, 24-14 now. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now Dak Prescott and the offense heading back onto the field. He's got to be feeling pretty good, playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm, throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. Prescott on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. All right, partner, we got Black Friday, Cyber Monday in the rearview mirror. Now it's football focus time, and it's getting towards the playoffs. If we look at the NFC playoff picture right now, legitimately, who can challenge the Cowboys?
Well, I think first and foremost, you're going to say Seattle, because of the way they play defense. If they get everyone back healthy, look out. That'd be a heck of a battle. But I'm going to give you one that may surprise you, and I think it's the New York Giants. And the reason being, that's their MO. They get hot late in the season, and they're always a good playoff team.
And they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And it'll be Viking football here as they take possession. And the Cowboys defense, they march back out onto the field. And a touchdown given up the last time they were out there, so maybe need to refocus a little bit.
And make sure that they don't start finger-pointing with each other, because oftentimes when a touchdown's given up, you say, okay, where did that happen? Who broke down? Who gave it up? Instead, just go back out there, be a unit again, and try and play a little bit better.
Yeah, see if they can play a little bit better on this drive. McKinnon to start the drive. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game, as we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Vikings are down right now, but they have to feel like they're still in it. The Cowboys deserve to be ahead, but we'll need to put together another strong half. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Third down from the 28. Impressive blocking frees up the ball carrier, and nobody can stop him on this long touchdown. They're now on top by 4. third down from inside the 50. Williams the target here, and he'll end up at the 20-yard line before being tackled. Continuing on the drive, Prescott's completion is made out of the gun. And now they get in for the touchdown, which takes the lead to 3. Cowboys line up at the 3. Elliott's looking for room to run, and he'd go in for the 3-yard touchdown. The Cowboys push the lead to 17. Vikings have it late in the first half. This run stays up the middle here, and this run goes for a touchdown, closing the gap to 10.
So that'll do it for us here in Orlando. For the call of the second half, let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They run it with McKinnon. A gain of 3, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Here again is McKinnon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Here's McKinnon, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
From our vantage point, that was just one bad play by the offensive line in a series of really good ones tonight. But I know that they're going to be really ticked off. It's a lot like a baseball pitcher losing a no-hitter late in the game.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11.
Hey, four down. There we go now.
They'll try to throw now. Bradford, he's got time. And complete, right side, the tight end Rudolph. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Offense faces a third and medium with 6 yards left.
Hey. Four down.
Bradford from the gun on third down. And Rudolph has it left side. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Now McKenna. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
So much for halftime adjustments by the defense, because you know they had to talk about it. The entire first half, they struggled to contain him. And here he is coming out in the second half and establishing the same tone. Still running the football with authority, still gaining big yardage. So I just figure in the offensive side, they said, well, there is no adjustment. Until they slow us down, keep going at him, keep handing him the football.
First carry of the game here for Matt Asiata. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Now a 2nd down throw for Bradford. And he will find his man on the outside. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
So they're operating in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, they're certainly running the ball pretty well on this drive, and all I remember as a secondary guy was if you're making a lot of tackles in a game, that's usually not good for your defense. You've got to figure out how to keep things in front of you, because you know there's 3 levels, defensive line, linebackers, and into the secondary. And if the 3rd level is leading your team in tackles, as a general rule, things aren't going so well for your defense.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
So the hard count gets them there. Neutral zone infraction.
Yeah, the defense thought they had the timing down, but the quarterback hit them with a hard count, got them to jump.
Come out here in the eye. 1st and goal here from the 2. Now Asiata. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. So stuffed from the 2. Now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Offense working with a 2nd and goal now from the 3. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Calling a gain of 2 as they're knocking on the door now. 3rd and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a 3rd time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Goal now. The defense looking to hold serve again. And he'll get nothing out of that one. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
He's had a big game tonight, and while no one's going to be overly concerned about that last play, you also know that the offense coordinator does not want to see that happen again. They want to get back to doing what they've been doing all game long.
Now the Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. Less than an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. And Forbath will put this one through, and this is back down to a 7-point game. So they get three. They were hoping for six. An unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
Horvath now to kick it away after the made field goal. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Fresh set of downs here.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, four down.
They come out here in the eye. Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Allen. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
That was a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Give to Elliott. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
Play action here on first down. Looking for his tight end, Witten, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
Naturally, we're going to say it was a poor pass, but the defensive guys say it was just a great play by them. They broke on the football, picked it off, and gave some momentum to their team.
Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
And the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And it'll be a Minnesota first down.
Most players will tell you that night games, while they can be fun, they're really hard to prepare for because you wake up on game day and all you want to do is get to the stadium and let's get going. But you got to bank that fire a little bit and hold it until the evening. It's almost like a Broadway premiere. Got to wait until the nighttime to go out there in front of the bright lights. And boy, has he harnessed himself really well. And now he's unleashing it on the opponents.
No gain on the play there. Second down. He had a great read there from his free safety position. And Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing. And on that play, he obviously had no presence to feel like he's being pushed for a pass. And without that, that allowed him to get up to the line of scrimmage and hold him to no gain.
Second down, Bradford. The left side caught by Diggs. Touchdown, Vikings. Stephon Diggs, 33 yards. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Now Forbath for the extra point. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And to cap it off, a touchdown run of 20 yards. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. This is taken at his 4. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Minnesota defense, we watch them get set to roll. And the interception for them the last time, and that turned into 6 points.
You think during their break they reminded the offense that, hey, we helped you guys
remember
out
that
a little
guys?
Bit,
yeah.
Right? You know, they want to see if they can do it again for them. They're putting together an entire team game by how they're playing on defense.
So the interception, the last drive, what will happen here? They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on and it's second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Ten yards still left on second down.
Four down, four down.
A 20th carry here for Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Offense needs 11, have to think pass here on third down. On third down, it's Prescott surveying the field. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
Looking forward pass, offense.
So the flag is for the very rare illegal forward pass penalty.
Not often that a quarterback forgets where the line of scrimmage is. They have an innate sense about it. On this play, the quarterback did.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, standing just outside his own goal line. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defense.
Yeah, what's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
The drive starts with a handoff to McKinnon. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game. And while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Really good, skillful, tough running throughout this contest. Picked up first down after first down. He's got to have a nickname, doesn't he? How about the human first down machine? I think that fits.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And they'll go on the ground. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll take this for about four up to the 46-yard line. Sean Lee, the Pro Bowler, there for the tackle.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
One receiver left, three to the right. On third down, Bradford, a dump down to McKinnon. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. A solid gain of of 15 yards and the sticks move.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Throwing, Bradford. He's going to look deep down the field. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day? You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
From the shotgun, it's Bradford. His pass caught at the four. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. They come out here in the eye. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage.
But that certainly felt like an example of the defense just saying, okay, we've had enough. We've gotten mashed all night long. About time we got a good play in. But flip it over to the offensive side. They've got to be really upset that they allowed a play like that to happen. They were pitching such a great game. They want to keep it going.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Now that was a big stop on third down. And this is where head coaches make their money and answer the question right here and now. Do you kick the field goal for the 3 points? Or do you go ahead and try and grab yourself a touchdown lead?
So here now is Kai Forbath with the pressure on. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And Forbath will put this one through, and that will break our tie and give them a 3-point lead. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know, the field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Forbath now to kick it away after the made field goal. Whitehead, the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On first and 10, Prescott. He hits Beasley right side. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
No matter how you evaluate quarterbacks, at some point arm strength is going to come into the conversation. I'm really impressed by what I saw on that throw on the out route.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Bryant, the lone receiver, left. Prescott on first down. He's got time in the pocket. It's caught on the right side. Williams. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And some options here for the offense on second and two. Here's Elliott. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Looks like a nickel set here defensively on third and two.
Yeah, maybe expecting a throw. Prescott on third and two. He completes it to Bryant. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
First down, Prescott. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. He's got the size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Let's go! One, nine.
From the red zone now, Prescott. His throw caught at about the five. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Cowboys have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. Bailey now for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. That time, a six-play drive. And it's finished off with a five-yard touchdown run. Now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken in at the one. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Play fake here on first down. Finding time. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
So second and 10 here. A second down throw for Bradford. A dump down to McKenna. It'll be a pickup of just two, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And on third down, the Cowboys bringing an extra defensive back. Off the play fake, Bradford. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Oh, he can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved a first pick of the game there, but at least it does get him to fourth down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that fell harmlessly to the ground. Here's Jeff Locke now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. Spinning past him. Spinning again. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. He'll get the football here. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Here's Prescott. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Remaining here on third down. On third down, it's Prescott. And that's caught by Beasley. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
On the counter, Elliott. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Prescott now on second down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target, and it's third down. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. It's a five-receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Prescott from the gun on third. He's got time. He completes it to Bryant. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Second down following the run. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Blitz coming and down he goes. A first-time Pro Bowler from a season ago, Anthony Barr, from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Prescott from the gun. And this is going to be incomplete. The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And that brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It will be a 51-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that'll make this a 7-point game. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You're able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Now, after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Bradford now to throw on first down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Nice, showed a little athletic juke, but then the daylight quickly closed.
Holding offense.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding.
Hey,
Time starting to run out here in the fourth. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. And Rudolph has it left side. That throw good for four. It's second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You're talking about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
Second down, Bradford surveying the field. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. Third and long for Bradford. And he's able to find Diggs. And he's going to be marked down deep in Dallas territory. Time for a break. He'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. In the red zone this time. Asiata here on the ground. It's a gain of a yard and it'll set up second and goal. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Back to throw. And his pass incomplete. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect them.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Looks like they might be expecting a pass, an extra DB in on third and goal.
That's how the game has changed. Now we think pass first, even in goal line situations.
The offense behind the chains after the infraction. It's now third down and 14. Back to throw. Screen play, McKinnon. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. It doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
And tough starting field position here. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he'll get him a little space here up to the 5-yard line. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Come
So second and medium, second and five now. Another carry for the rookie, Elliott. And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. And another timeout called by the Vikings now. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down.
Four down.
They come out here in the eye. Now Elliott. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. From Minneapolis, good night, everybody.